And now we discuss the cellular telephone systems. And this is the regular cellular phones that we have today. The cellular telephone systems provides a wireless connection to the PSTN for any user within the radio range of the system. So we will see in a diagram later that a typical cellular cell, actually is a region that is defined as being served by one base station or BTS. So this is what we also call famously as tower. Therefore, we might have a mobile station there. So we are saying as long as the user is within the range, and the range is the distance from the tower to the farthest edge of the cell where a reliable signal or the radio signal is going to be received. Cellular systems accommodate a large number of users, therefore over a large geographical area. This sometimes can be as large as 5 kilometers. So 5 kilometers is a huge area that can be served by a cell, or that consists of a cell, and therefore that can be served by one base station. And therefore we are saying that this one cell may consist of many number of users. And therefore, these users are going to be served within a limited frequency spectrum. This one cell operates in a given frequency range, and therefore all the users within this frequency range may be served by that frequency range or spectrum. Cellular radio systems provide high quality of service or high quality service or high quality calls compared to the other cordless systems that we have talked about or paging systems, because technically these are almost equivalent, or the kind of quality that is provided by the cellular telephone system is almost as good as that is offered by the PSTN or by the landline telephone systems. However, the cellular telephone systems provide very high capacity even compared to the landline, because one landline may serve limited users, but cell has quite a huge capacity in terms of channels that may support simultaneous calls. And therefore, high capacity is achieved by limiting the coverage of each base station. So if we reduce the size or the radius of one base station, then it will still maintain high capacity of serving more users. And for that reason, we say that when we limit the radius or the coverage of each base station, then the same base station may serve as many users as a large base station. Therefore, the higher the smaller the base station size or the cell sizes, the bigger the number of users that the system itself can support. There is a concept of reuse that we are going to be discussing in a subsequent chapter. So for now, I will not really go into too much depth regarding that concept of how we achieve higher capacity when we have smaller cells. That we are going to be discussing under the concept of frequency reuse. We are now saying that a sophisticated switching technique called handoff enables calls to proceed uninterrupted even when the user moves from one cell to another. And I mentioned that concept even in the previous section, but we are going to be discussing it in full. This is an illustration of a cellular system. The towers represent base stations which provide radio access between mobile users and the mobile switching center, or famously known as MSC. So you can see that this is a region that has been divided into many cells. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, I think 11 or 12 there. So this might be covering an entire county, and the county may be served by say 12, 13 base stations, just to illustrate. And therefore each of the cell is served by one BTS or one tower, the towers that you will see being erected by Safaricom or even other mobile network providers. So some few features regarding the cellular telephone system. We see that from figure 3 above, a basic cellular system consists of a mobile station, a base station, and a mobile switching center. So each of those three must be there for communication to happen. So a base station cannot communicate on itself, but again, it cannot process the calls that it receives. The task of managing the calls, managing the billings, interconnecting the these stations is performed by mobile switching center. The mobile switching center is sometimes called mobile telephone switching office because it is responsible for connecting all mobiles to the PSTN. So we normally say that calls might be wireless. This is my BTS. This might be a mobile user. It wants to call a landline, and therefore a landline is no more probably an office whose phone number might start with 020 or 065. So these are landlines that are classified at the PSTN. So this call that is coming from a mobile user is going to be connected to the PSTN by what is famously known as MSC. So MSC receives the calls from the BTS. This BTS is also managed by the BSC, and we are going to be discussing those details in a future subsection. But for now, it suffices to say that the MSC will connect the BTS or a cellular user, a mobile station user, to a landline that is at a different infrastructure of landline. So each mobile communicates via radio with one of the base stations, as we have seen. So it is sending some signals wirelessly, the idea we are saying that when you say wirelessly, that is the radio, with one of the base stations, and may be handed off to any number of base stations throughout the duration of call. So the call may start when we are in this base station, but then we move to another base station, and then our call is routed from the earlier base station A to base station B. And therefore, the call is now going to be connected by that. Assume someone is driving in a car or being carried by a car. When they move from one region to another, the calls are continually being handed off. That is the concept of handover, handed off between one base station to another base station. The mobile station consists of a transceiver. That means it is able to receive and send signals. An antenna. The antenna is the one that now manages the signals that are received by the transceiver. And the control circuitry, we are able to start a call and end a call. And this may be mounted on a vehicle, or may be used by a portable handheld unit. This is what we technically do every day. We are able to walk around or even walk a driver in vehicles. That capacity is only achievable by a cellular telephone. Now, the base station consists of several transmitters. Just be aware that the BTS that I'm drawing like a triangle here may have more than one transmitter. So these are antennas that are capable of communicating with several users. So one antenna might connect to several users, another antenna might connect to several users, etc., etc. So do not be confused when you hear that a base station consists of several transmitters and receivers, which simultaneously, the keyword here is very important, simultaneously had a full duplex communication and generally have towers that support several transmitting and receiving antennas I have just stated. So further, base station serves as a bridge between all mobile users in the cell and connects the simultaneous mobile calls via telephone lines or microwave links to the MSC. So the idea here we are saying is that the base station is a bridge connecting mobile users, but now between one base station or one BTS to another BTS, which now allows one to connect to the MSC. Not all BTSs are not connected to the MSC, because one might be in the forest and the closest one might be in the town, where in town there is fiber. So the connection from the town BTS to the MSC is quite straightforward. It can happen via fiber. But the one that is in the forest to the one that is nearest town, this might happen via microwave link, which is a point-to-point connection, a direct point-to-point connection. It might happen via telephone lines, like a wired connection, or you might even use fiber. So sometimes you might be able to connect a BTS using fiber, or sometimes you might even connect them using the microwave links. So we also say that the MSC coordinates the activities of all the base stations and connects the entire cellular system to the PSTN. That is a concept that we have already seen. A typical MSC handles up approximately 100,000 cellular subscribers and can support maybe 5,000 simultaneous calls at a time and accommodates all billing and system maintenance functions as well. So we are saying that as much as a mobile or an MSC may support 100,000, they may not support all of them at the same time, because they, in a normal life, not all people call at the same time. Therefore, some callers, some subscribers may call now, others may call 1 hour later, etc. So we are seeing that all of those may be supported by one MSC, but then simultaneous calls are fewer than the number of subscribers that are supported. In large cities, MSCs are used by a single carrier. So as sometimes, probably in the cases of a big city like Nairobi, the calls, the BTSs might be very many, and the limit of one MSC might be exceeded. Therefore, you might have more than one MSC supporting multiple BTSs, and therefore each of the MSCs are interconnected to deliver the services that that are required. Therefore, we are saying that some large cities may be supported by several MSCs. But in a non-populated city or region, then one MSC might be sufficient to connect one region. So we might have, say, in a country like ours, I'm not doing very well, but we might realize that the country might be divided into different regions. Each of the regions are supported by different MSCs. So MSC 1, MSC 2. We are going to discuss this architecture in a later section. For now, we are just laying the groundwork, and we say that that is purely the function. So the billing might happen in either of these MSCs, that you're able to know that, and even the maintenance, as we have seen. Communication between the base station and the mobile is defined by a standard common air interface called CA1 that specifies four different channels. There are four channels that the air interface is capable of supporting. The first two are for voice transmission. So one is between the base station to the mobile, that is the one I call downlink. And then the forward voice channels are the ones that are classified as uplink. These are the ones that support the voice transmission from the mobile to the base station. Sorry, of course, the forward voice channels are the ones that connect the base station to the mobiles, whereas the reverse voice channels are the ones that connect the voice calls from the mobile to the base station. So this is the one that I refer to as the uplink. Uplink channels, also called reverse voice channels, whereas the downlink voice channels are also referred to as the voice forward voice channels. Finally, we want to say that the two channels responsible for initiating mobile calls are the forward control channels and the reverse control channels. And the control channels are often called setup channels because they are only involved in setting up a call or moving it to an unused voice channel. So as we have seen, we have four channels available, or four types of channels. One channel types. Two are for voice. One is for up. The other one is for down. You have seen the one for down is the one that you are calling forward voice channels. The other one for uplink are the one you are referring to as the reverse voice channels. Whereas now, after the voice, we see that the second category is the one that is called control channels. And again, there are two of them, the one that control the setting up of calls, they control the setting up of calls, and the other calls that are used for stopping the calls. So that is technically the two categories of channels. So the forward control channels serve as beacons, which continually broadcast all the traffic requests for the mobiles in the system. So I think this is the concept of beacon is quite familiar, that you might be in a room and with some speaker or some radio, or might be watching a television, but then when a call is coming, you hear some sound that tells you that there's a call that's about to start. So that kind of a beacon is the one that is, that kind of a sound or signals that are sometimes received even by the radio or by the TV, are the ones that are called beacons. So here's a small quiz. You may look at it for your general understanding, and some of these quizzes are going to be examinable, so take some time to look at them and prepare you with understanding of the concepts that we have so far discussed.